In this video, we're talking about how to take a sum and rewrite it in summation notation. And in this particular problem, we've been given this sum here. So 1 half plus 1 fourth plus 1 eighth, 1 16th, 1 32nd, and 1 over 64, 1 64th. What we need to do is use summation notation to simplify this sum. So when we talk about summation notation, we mean sigma notation. So we have this sigma value here with n equal to something. We're going to have a number here on top of the sigma notation, and we're going to need to find a function that represents this sum. So this is a tricky thing to learn how to do, but basically what it comes down to is you're just looking for patterns, and sometimes they're going to be more complicated than others. In this case, we're going to do a really simple one so that we can get the feel for it. But all we're doing is looking for patterns. So if we look at this sum, the first thing we notice is every one of these terms is a fraction, and the numerator of each of the fractions is 1. So it's a pretty good bet that the function that represents this sum is going to be a fraction where the numerator is 1. So let's just go ahead and write that. The denominator is a little bit trickier because the number changes each time. But what we see is that they're all multiples of 2. In fact, they're all powers of 2. So we could actually rewrite these denominators. We could call this one 2 to the first power. We could call this one 2 squared because 2 squared is 4. We know that 2 to the third is 8, so we could say this is 2 to the third. We know that 2 to the fourth power is 16, so this is 2 to the fourth. 32 is 2 to the 5th, and 64 is 2 to the 6th power. So since that's the case, the denominator of our function is probably going to have base 2. The only issue is that the exponent here always changes. Notice it's counting up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So how do we deal with that if we want to write a function that represents this sum? Well, what you always need to remember, and you should go ahead and write this below each term in your expanded sum, is that this first term is usually going to correspond to either n equals 0 or n equals 1. In this case, it's going to be n equals 1, and I'll show you why in a second. So if we say this is going to be n equals 1, this is going to be n equals 2, n equals 3, n equals 4, n equals 5, and n equals 6. You always just count up from either 1 or 0. It's just really a matter of whether or not you're starting with n equals 1 or n equals 0. But wherever you start, you count up from that number one integer at a time. But now, if we say that for this term n is equal to 1, well, this is 1 here, so that could be n. Here, if n is equal to 2, this is 2, so that could be n. Here, n is equal to 3, and this exponent is 3, so that could be n. So what we see is that if we assign values n equals 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 that correspond with each of these terms, then what this really becomes is 1 over 2 to the n. And 1 over 2 to the n can represent each of these terms as long as n starts at 1. If we had said n starts at 0, if we'd started at n equals 0 and then done n equals 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, then this first exponent right here would have been n plus 1 because this would have been the n equals 0 term. And to get to 1 here, we would have had to add 1, so it would have been the same as n plus 1. And we could have done that. We could have said n equals 0, and then the function would have been 1 over 2 to the n plus 1. But it's cleaner just to say n equals 1 so that we can start this at 1 over 2 to the n. And then what we can say is, since this series ends at n equals 6, we'll say the index is n equals 1 up to 6. And now this is summation notation that represents this series. And if we want to double check ourselves, all we have to do is plug this back in. So here we start at n equals 1 and we know we're going to go up to 6. But if we plug in n equals 1 first, what we're going to get is 1 over 2 to the first power, or 1 over 2. If we then start counting up and we say n equals 2, we plug in n equals 2, we're going to get 1 over 2 squared, or 1 fourth. Plugging in n equals 3, we're going to get 2 cubed, or 8, so we get 1 eighth. And we could keep going up to n equals 6. If we plug in n equals 6, we're going to get 1 over 2 to the 6th power, or 1 over 64. And what you can see is that this expanded sum is the same as the expanded sum we were given in our original problem. We start at 1 half, we go up 6 terms, and we end at 1 over 64, and all the terms in the middle are going to match these original terms. What that tells us is that we did this correctly, and that 1 over 2 to the n does represent this expanded sum. And so we can say then that this is our final answer here, and this is the summation notation of the original sum. Could you use some extra help with math? Click the button to head over to calculusexpert.com. It's where I've collected and organized all of my best resources, including exclusive videos, notes, quizzes, and even formula sheets. It's the perfect resource whether you're struggling, or if you want to take your learning further, or even if you just want to save yourself some time studying. So check it out, because I know it'll help.